you want to take it from 4 to Q, you better bring it.
It's men versus men.
The top fundraiser award is the prize that Florida Cube covets.
Please come get us. If you can come get that trophy out of our hands, it's yours. I'll hand it to you personally, but I don't think you're going to do it. My name is Drew Harrington, and I am the team captain and president of Team Florida Q. I have three boys, twins that are 14 years old, and I've got a young 8-year-old, all boys, and I have a very loving and patient wife. Team Florida Q has evolved into, I would say, probably the largest team that competes at Hogs. We've gotten so big and so well organized that we are our own 501c3.
My name is Trimble Green. I'm a founding member of Team Florida Q. I believe it's been 7 years since we founded it with just a 10 by 10 tent and one smoker where we all slept on the ground in a tent. My duties as a board member is really just to be a sounding board for so many different ideas that everyone has. Everyone on this group, whether they're board members or not, brings so many ideas to the table that we have to sift through the ones that we can really follow through with, the ones that we can't. And then on game day, I guess I'm more of a frozen drink maker and social chairman.
Okay, I am Craig. Who do I look at? Do I look at you? All right, I am Craig Brewer. I am the secretary of the Florida Q organization. I started out cooking ribs, which was kind of a disaster. So I got taken off the rib cooking team. I wear a few other hats. I like to think of myself as the offensive coordinator, which means that I'm basically a support service for everything that's going on and trying to make sure everybody has what they need in order to, you know, have a successful Hog for the Cause. Basically, I'm herding a bunch of cats.
My name is Brad Gottsagen. I am the treasurer of Florida Q, the webmaster and social media guru, and I make a pretty damn good barbecue sauce. So this trophy is the original top fundraising trophy that Hogs presented. Now, we've now won top fundraiser, I think, 5 years in a row, and it sits in my waiting room in all its glory for everybody to enjoy.
Don't be kind of mooching in on my space here.
My name is Rodney LaCoste. I've been a member of Team Florida Q. This will be going into my fourth year. Last year would have been my third Hogs event. And I'm also currently a member of the board of Florida Q.
I'm Richard Carnes. Rodney and I joined the team at the same time. I'm also on the board, member of the booth committee as well with Rodney.
My name is Lee Finkelstein. I am a board member of Team Florida Q. I've been on the team for about 5-6 years. I don't know if my role on the team, I don't know if I have a role. Most people say that I like to tell people what to do and then sit back and watch. It's basically probably what I'm best at.
Lee Finkelstein had approached me. I was so touched by what he told me about Hogs. I mean, we're so lucky to be able to walk around and for me to be able to do this interview, and you know, my eyes work and my brain works all right, and I just wanted to do whatever I could do to help him. And I thought it was so cool that Florida Q is this like group of men who are so empowered to help raise money for something like this, because I think generally it would be a group of women is what we would think. But how awesome that there are these dads and businessmen and, you know, successful people that are just helping out these families.
Talk to Drew Harrington, our leader, he'll say, you know, Florida Q is a fundraising team with a barbecue problem. I'm Jay Adams, I'm on Team Florida Q. I think Hogs to Cause is a very important event. I think it shines a light on an area of fundraising where I don't think there's been a lot of conventional resources placed.
There is not as much attention that's given to pediatric cancer in general, and not as much attention given to kids with brain tumors.
I feel so fortunate that I'm able to say to families who are here saying, I don't know what we are going to do. I can't go to work, my kid's in the hospital, and they legitimately don't know what they're going to do. And I explain, you know what, there are these guys who met one family, decided to have a barbecue, and now it's a 90 plus probably at this point team festival, and they're raising money for families like you.
My name is Ben Surratt. I'm born and raised in New Orleans. My affiliation with Hawks for the Cause, it was founded for my oldest boy, little Ben, who was diagnosed with diffuse intrinsic pontine glioma, which is an extremely rare pediatric brain cancer.
You know, little Ben has just brought a lot of different people together in this event that otherwise would never have met.
I run Team Hog That Nation now. Hogs was founded in 2008 by Renee Luop and Becker Hall. It's very personal to me. You know, I have the connection that it started for my son, but it's grown into something so much more than that. You know, we give grants to families all over the country. So we get letters back from these families saying, thank you. You know, you were able to help us catch up on our bills, or you were able to help us buy groceries.
Most of our families end up having Medicaid or insurance that covers a lot of those medical costs. What's not covered are the things like not being at work anymore. And so families then have to deal with, you know, I'm not having an income, so I can't take care of my regular expenses and my regular household costs.
The world outside of here doesn't stop. And I know many parents feel just that sense of being overwhelmed because there's so many things that they're trying to multitask while they're focusing on one of their biggest priorities, which is the health of their kids.
You know, just to make a $200 payment or a $50 copay, it helps us out greatly. And, you know, I appreciate to have an immediate friend that I didn't even know in Hawks for Cause.
One of the little trailers that goes on the bottom of all the emails that we get from the board from Hogs, it says on the bottom, together we can do something great. And it really does show.
It is such an exciting event, and it's even more exciting when I think about the progress that we've made and what we've been able to accomplish as a team, and be able to provide such an economic stimulus for the area of pediatric brain cancer.
Drew has an unwavering enthusiasm for this event, this charity, what our team, Florida Q, does. He's really, I think he's an inspiration to everyone because, you know, we mentioned it off camera, because every time you run into Drew, he wants to talk about Hawks for the Cause or Florida Q or doing something to help someone. He has this incredible capacity for, you know, wanting to do things to help other people. And if you've ever heard Drew's personal story about how he got interested in this charity, it's heartbreaking, but also inspiring at the same time. You understand, because of his emotional connection and what happened to him, his dedication to the cause. And that's an inspiration.
In 2005, a young family member, cousin, was diagnosed with neuroblastoma. He was right around 4 years old. Very similar family dynamic. These are cousins that have three boys, similar age groups to my kids. Sammy did not survive. He passed away the year before we entered the competition. And it's been one of the main reasons why I chose this charity to support.
All 45 guys on our team are inspired by his commitment and his dedication.
We show up on Monday to start getting ready for the event that really starts on Friday.
One of the ways that I try to explain what we do is that we build a restaurant to serve over 1,000 people with food and beverage in 4 days, and we take it down in 2 days. So you can imagine all of the detail and planning that's got to go into that in order to pull that off.
itself. You know, there was a team the previous year that came out and did a really nice job of putting together a corporate facade that was beautiful. And we were all jealous of it. And we were like, all right, well, if these guys are going to come out with this show, I think it was House of Hogs that did it. And when they came out with these beautifully manicured decorations, we're like, all right, they just threw the gauntlet down. They have no idea what kind of sleeping giant they woke up.
This is Ed Douglas coming to you from the House of Hogs exhibit. Last year was our first year, and I think we proved our point. We won first place for exhibit last year, and we hope to do the same this year. At the very least, we've made everybody else step up a little bit in their exhibit planning.
And Rodney was like, that's the first thing he looked at me. He goes, we're going double-decker. And I'm not kidding you, right there on the spot, he made the phone call, secured the scaffolding, and we started putting the drawings together on how this was gonna go. We submitted permits to the city. The first two times we talked about it, the Hogs organizers were like, no way. And we said, look, you know, we're the first to do a lot of things, and this is one of the things we're gonna do.
Rodney Lacoste and Richard Currents, I mean, this was their idea, and I've mentioned it to them directly that I didn't dream in a million years I could actually pull that off, particularly for this year. I thought this is a great long-term goal to do all this, but they compressed that schedule and they got a commitment from the scaffolding company and had plans drawn up, and by the time, you know, 6 months after Hogs 2015, we had a plan.
Day one has been a great success. The weather's cooperated, and tomorrow looks clear too, so we're off to a running start. It's gonna be big. We always intended for it to be sizable, and I think you can see it's really gonna be the hit.
We did all the prefab in Slidell. We only worked on the weekends, so people gave up their Saturdays and Sundays, and some guys drove quite a ways. And without them, we weren't going to get it done.
Richard Currents and Rodney Lacoste planning the booth and working on it, and I got to go over and work with them, and they put in lots of time. And thinking of it and all coming together was really, really special.
You going with us? Everything is loaded. All the inside walls are in the covered trailer, and everything else is on Kenny's. That's a 30 to 40 foot trailer. So we have about 40 minutes from cracking a beer up there when we get there. All right, we're on our way.
Bye. So I fixed my boot.
And you glued it, it looks like.
I did glue it. I'm so proud that my work boots are actually starting to look like work boots.
Do you have any concept of what the booth is going to look like? Good news is, neither do we. We kept and modified last year's facade, but that only covers about 25% of the entirety. It's going to be really big.
Fireworks shooting.
Oh, man. But you think this is it?
Oh, no,
you think
no,
that's
no.
It?
I know it's not.
It's been another productive day. We were over in Slidell all afternoon loading out the trailers and getting everything ready to get over here. So tomorrow's a big day. Everything starts to show up by 8 o'clock in the morning, and the weather's supposed to get here by midday. We would really like to make hay tomorrow morning. And, you know, I think that we will, but, you know, we're just going to muscle through.
It's like, all right, I kind of remember what pieces go where. That's gonna be fun. Now I remember the panels, and I'm like, how did we stack the panels? We'll figure it out. Yeah, it's a jigsaw puzzle. Just hope we have most of the pieces.
This is
just gets bigger and bigger and bigger. So we just keep pushing the envelope. I mean, but it just makes everybody else better. Everybody else, like these guys didn't have this like this last year. There's some
new. Being a member of Team 40Q really means the ability to give back. Give back to the community, because most of the people that are on this team are very fortunate. We've been lucky enough to have healthy kids, and we just like the ability to come into something like this and see people that need the help. And we can't, so we do.
Rodney LaCoste in the red shirt.
I met Rodney.
The guy in charge of construction all day.
And he pointed me in your direction. He says, go talk to Drew, see if he needs any help.
Yeah, we drafted anybody that would swing a hammer. And put in the work.
I've never been involved with a group of guys that are so totally dedicated to a singular task, and we all seem to put important things in our lives aside, not only FlirtyQ, but also Hogs for the Cause and the families that it benefits.
Crescent Crown Distributing, where we picked up some delicious Miller High Life ponies.
We want people to understand we're not using the money we raise to pay for that stuff. That's all donated. And that's a pretty cool thing that we're able to pull off. 100% of the money that we raise from donors goes directly into the Hogs for the Cause Fund that gets paid out in grants to families who need it. And that's, I know we're jumping ahead probably to a question, but that feels real good.
We are en route to Abita Springs to go to the Abita Brewery to pick up some delicious craft beer that has been donated. The thing that's nice about the donations we get for the Friday night party is that the Friday night party gives us the opportunity to thank all of the donors that give us money. So it's a pretty good blowout, and the fact that these guys are willing to help us throw that party by donating, it just allows us to put that much more money into the kitty for the kids.
I don't know if you can hear that lovely noise in the background, but I can say it again if you wish. That's to keep birds out of the brewery, so it kind of scares them away. My name's Rachel Cole. I am a beer guide here at the Abita Brewery, located in lovely Abita Springs, Louisiana. And we are donating beer to Hogs for a Cause today. Oh.
What I really like about our donors is they get it. They get what we're doing. Is it good to get your name out there? Absolutely. I mean, and these guys that give us money, we try to give them as much recognition as we can, because it is important and it's a big thing. They're giving their money, they're giving their time, they're giving product. You guys are incredible. You guys are what make this happen. And if we didn't have you, you know, we wouldn't be able to put on not only a fantastic event, but to relieve this pressure from families that are just going through scary stuff.
Happy to you. Today's the end of day four. We've completed the inside of the bar 95%. We're ready for the party tomorrow night. Tonight we're having a little team party to christen her, and everything's looking great.
What he said.
the typhoon of this year.
When the rain started coming down on Friday, and trust me, we're used to the rain at Hogs for the Cause. It seems to happen every year. We all kind of rolled our eyes and said, okay, here it comes again, we're gonna deal with this. And then the water became almost biblical, and it rained, and it rained. And when you see ducks swimming around in rain ponds on the field, you know you have a big problem.
You just switch into what can we get done mode, how do we protect the booth mode. At this point, most of us have been through enough of it that we understood, gonna get wet, gotta dry this place out, and gotta get ready.
I got on the bar side, I've got buckets now. Just one dripping right onto the bar.
We knew it was gonna rain, right? We said it's gonna rain.
Because the rain happened in the middle of the day and rained almost all afternoon, it really threw our cooking teams off their game, I think, because everything got set back hours and hours, and just in terms of preparation, getting the smokers going, doing all the things we needed to do. There was nothing to do for 4 or 5 hours while it was raining other than try to keep water out of the booth.
You know, one of the guys that was with us, he ran out to put the trash pump hose in to start sucking water and tripped over something and fell flat into the water. Came back with his knee boots on and was pulling them off and emptying the water out. I think the last thing he said was, all right, enough of this, let's go fill this boot with beer and let's get this party going. And that's kind of what we did, so.
The very first flag raising for the 2016 Hogs for the Cause Fleur de Q booth. We stormed this beach and we took it.
Literally, it's a beach. We're on the beach.
It's a beach, we took it. We're really on the water.
It's more of an island.
It's a swampy island, but we'll take it. That's all we got.
That's all we got.
Harumph.
So what, you going with just salt and pepper? Is that it?
Nope. This shit's gonna be great.
Or it's gonna be awful.
Friday night party. A lot soggy, but it's still going on.
A little swampy.
Yeah. It's all for the kids.
The food's good, the meat's better, the cause is the best. What else can you ask for?
One of my favorite times of the entire event is early Saturday morning. We get there early and, you know, it's kind of quiet, but all the smoke is going across the field and all the teams are sort of cranking up and getting ready, and it gives you time and sort of reflect on what we're doing.
So it's an early rise to make sure the smokers are still going, make sure that all the recipes are in order and all the food prep, which has been going on all night, is still in motion. You know, even though it sounds like a whole lot of work, Saturday is what it's all about. It's a lot of fun, and that's when you start seeing the general public and having everybody come through the tent. You're just trying to impress and wow everybody. We have everybody broken out. We have servers. We've got people that are just supposed to keep drinks flowing to the crowd. We've got people who are taking garbage out.
Then it, you know, rolls into, you gotta start getting the food ready. You know, there's a very specific timeline during the day of when the different things need to be turned in. Pork shoulder, ribs, whole hog, the pork puree. And so we've got, you know, teams that do those specific things, but we also have a team that takes care of putting together the presentation box that is taken to the judges.
Alright, tighten that up. You'll go take it to your station.
It is.
Captain of the Judges?
It's food art. It is, yeah. Food art.
Barbecue in itself is one of those things that there's no definition for. I mean, last year we had 92 teams or 93 teams, and about 80 of the teams turned in the sauce category. So that's 80 different tastes on what they think barbecue sauce is.
Also have a team that actually sells the food out of the front of the booth, which is another important part of our fundraising activity. And it's very important because, you know, we always joke amongst ourselves that we want to sell out our food, like us on the shoulder team want to sell out the shoulder. So that's a lot of fun for us to work on that. So that goes on during the day. And then once your product, whatever it is, in our case shoulder, is to the judges, then that's, you kind of can let your hair down a little bit and kind of relax.
They all get to go to the event as VIPs. So it's really wonderful to go out there and see them, you know, enjoying their day with their families. All the siblings are invited, you know, you see everybody, and it makes for a really special day.
It's our second year that we come to host for the cause, due to the fact that Kira has NF1 neurofibromatosis type 1. We were able to be helped by them with a grant about 2 years ago, just to make things a little less difficult for her. Well, she underwent chemotherapy for about a year.
Oh.
to see today how resilient the people in New Orleans are, that they show up with the adversity of the weather and the circumstances and do what they did today, it's a beautiful thing, and the kids are the ones that win on the deal, so it's awesome.
Funny of this, you're at 93,560. It's 583 in cash.
583 in cash.
There's 260 in chips. That gets us to a little over $94,000. And we weren't happy, so we're writing another check.
55,500 to bring us to $150,000.
All good.
That's why we're here, bro.
Means a lot, guys.
All good stuff.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you for all your hard work. Thank all of y'all.
Got out there recording.
Got it.
This one was hard. The weather and trying to clean up everything. We got a lot of guys that can cook. We got a lot of guys that can fundraise. We got a lot of guys that can go out and help out, work their tail off, build this thing behind us. We got the only two-story venue out here. And it's not a one-man show. We got, there's no eye in team, and we don't have any eyes on this team. So I'm proud to be here, brother. We'll see what happens. Let's go to awards.
Competition is sponsored by Children's Hospital of New Orleans, who's just been an amazing partner for us.
You have no idea what it means to us to see you out here having a fantastic time after everything we went through yesterday. Give a big round of applause to all of our teams.
Amazing!
We're going to get started on some food categories, but I want to welcome a few people before we do that.
I don't like any of the other people out there. I mean, none of them are as good as us, and none of their barbecue is better than us. I don't know why we haven't won an award for our food, because I think it's fixed, because hands down, the people that are at the event have told us that we're the best.
You know, I don't spend every weekend cooking. You know, that's a lot of these guys do that. That's what they do.
I wish we could cook a little bit better.
Not our responsibility.
Maybe one of these days we can win some food categories.
To be honest, I mean, we really got to do a better job on our food. We do such a great job raising money, but we just cannot cook meat that tastes good. So I think that's really important for us.
So this is best booth. Third place, best booth. I'm staring at him right now. Puerto Rico! All right, this is where it gets down to the dirty. Second place, best booth. They were last year's champion and best booth. House of Hogs, come to the stage. All right, the winner, this year's winner of, with a bottle of Cat Hand Vodka, best booth goes to Florida Q.
Want to give a big thanks as well to Rodney Lacoste for helping out yesterday, and Drew and all these guys. They did a fantastic job helping us pump out.
Let's get down to business. This is the top three fundraising teams, ladies and gentlemen. Big round of applause.
Woo, 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 woo.
Number three, our dear friends, Boar's Nest.
How much they raised, Andy? Tell everybody.
Boar's Nest raised $55,000 this year, everyone.
Way to go, first bucket.
Raising more than $75,000. My boys from Atlanta.
GA.
Fox Brothers Barbecue.
Capricorn recording artist. Fox Brothers Barbecue.
If you are ever in Atlanta, which we all know you really shouldn't go if you're a Saints fan, you should go to Fox Brothers Barbecue. It's some of the best. All right, let's clear this stage off, because we know there are about 800 people coming up here right now. It makes me think of it when I look up in the sky and I see this big, beautiful rotating pig. A back to back to back to back to, I don't even know if anyone has ever won this award in the modern generation. Ladies and gentlemen, raising over $150,000, Team Flirticue.
Our first fundraising trophy, you know, we all looked at each other and said, there's no way this trophy shouldn't be ours every year. You know, let's make a point of organizing the fundraising side of this, because that's what it's all about, period. Now, there may be somebody somewhere down the road that knocks us off, and I hope they do, because if they do, that means they worked hard, and that means they raised a lot of money. You know, here we are sitting at $150,000 this past year. You know, I hope we can continue to grow that. I mean, the first year we won it, I think we were, I don't know, 18, 19,000, and we thought, there's no way we're gonna top this. And every year it keeps doubling and doubling and doubling, and, you know, we're committed, so, you know, please come get us. Come get us. If you can come get that trophy out of our hands, it's yours, and I'll hand it to you personally, but I don't think you're gonna do it.
Well, I actually didn't go on stage. I was up on the upper deck kicking back watching those guys, which actually gives me great satisfaction to see the culmination of all of that work for months and months, and then that hyperactivity for 2 days, and to see all those guys really up there celebrating, going crazy. I really enjoy that. I don't think I've ever actually gotten up on a stage, just because I like to watch those guys, you know, up there celebrating. It makes me happy to see that. And you know, on the fundraising thing, I'm obviously very proud of what we do. It is the number one goal of this team is to raise money. Second goal is to have a great time. Third goal, well, some people would argue with that, but third goal is maybe to win some food categories. You know, the amount and the title isn't as important to me as feeling like we've succeeded, and that we've set out a goal to clip the number from the prior year, and we've done it every year, usually exponentially. And then we're knowing that we're gonna help 50 families or more with grants. That's what's important to me. I mean, we like winning the title more for trash talking, I think, than anything. But let me put it this way. One of the hardest things to think about is if you're a parent and you have children, you live in fear of something happened to them. And so when you hear about these families and what they're going through, you want to help them.
So let's not short circuit the stage.
Whatever we can raise, I'm telling you, it is not impossible to beat us. And I challenge every one of y'all to come after us, because we want you to beat us.